Good morning, guys. Happy Tuesday. I am en route to take Mr. Dallas to the pet groomer finally, because he is a hot mess back there. So yeah, I'm about to finally get his hair cut, and then I'm gonna stop by the house to see what's going on. Last week they were doing the landscaping, and so hopefully this week he said that they'll be doing, like, putting up the fence and all that good stuff like that. But how are you guys doing? How was your weekend? I had a really, really good weekend. Didn't do too much. Went to a housewarming party, church, and came back home. That's it. That's it, guys. Anyway, I will catch you guys in a little bit. After I drop him off and probably get some footage of the house when I get there. All right, guys. Dallas. Are you ready, baby? Dallas. You ready? He's ready. All right, guys, we're about to head in. Wow. Wow, so I turned down my street and it looks like everybody's getting grass. Grass, what I'm talking about, grass. I'm gonna go inside and see what they're doing to my place. Dallas is back, look at him.
Get it.
He do not like smelling good. Stop that.
Get it.
Dallas.
Dallas. Smell back on.
He hates smelling good, boy. Look at his hair. It looks so nice. I can see his eyes. They got him a cute little collar.
Smell like strawberries.
Hey, mama. Yeah, he smells so good. Hey, Dallas. Hi. You can see now. Look at that collar. Looks so cute. Hey, baby. He looks so handsome. We can finally see your eyes. Say, what is it, Dad? He looks so cute. Oh, he's so cute. I like that little place. Up, your collar fell off. His dad got him a bone. He not even worried about that bone. I'ma get it. You better come get it. Sit. Dallas, you are so cute. Cute little Yorkie. Hey guys, so I am currently en route to the gym. Looking like a ragamuffin, but hey, I'm going to work out. It is what it is. Anyway, as always, on either Tuesday or Wednesday, it's date night, so I'm about to get this hour and a half in, come back, shower, and honey say he's taking me somewhere. He didn't even tell me, so he just said, go ahead and work out and come on back and get all dolled up. Last week I didn't get all dressed up and stuff like that, but tonight I think I'll look a little cute for him since he's taking the time to put thought into where he wants to go. So I could appreciate that. And yeah, I'm going to weigh in tomorrow. Yeah, I have been snacking all day. That's my problem. I really need to stop snacking. I have a hard time. And yesterday when I left the gym, I went grocery shopping and picked up chips, cookies, cakes, oatmeal pies, and all that for the kids. And I said, okay, Tiffany, you're not gonna touch it. Don't touch it. I've been snacking in those snacks all day. Anyway, I will catch you guys when we head out tonight. guys, that was a really good workout. So now I did about an hour and 15 minutes. Time is now, it's about 5:40. So now I'm headed home to shower and see what the night brings. Okay, guys. Hey guys, date night has officially begun. Say hey, babe.
Hey, babe.
I still don't know where he's taking me. Where are you taking me?
I don't know. I'm just driving. We're gonna find somewhere to go.
Knowing him, it's somewhere he likes.
It's definitely gonna be somewhere I like. That you know that.
Yeah. Yeah. It's 7:19, and we are just leaving home. Yeah, we're just leaving home, so. As I said before, I don't know what he has in store for tonight, or I don't know anything. I think he be trying to surprise me because I surprised him.
That was a birthday gift. I don't have nothing to do with nothing.
I surprised you for your birthday.
Well, this is not your birthday.
Is it just because?
It's a day of the week.
Well, don't I feel special? Anyway, I will catch you guys a little bit later. About to do whatever he got us doing. All right, guys. All right, guys, we made it. We had to come to the ATM because we valet parked and they only take cash. So now babe is getting some money so we can grow. But yeah, we are going to have dinner at the Hard Rock Cafe, which we haven't been here in years. And actually, he proposed to me right across the street. Right up under that thing right there. You can't really see it clearly, but yeah, hopefully we'll have time enough to go and check it out.
We're ready.
And we're ready. Hey guys, so I'm having the usual. My apple martini, and babe is having his hurricane. Overload hurricane. Then he upgraded it. So. I decided to go with a burger tonight, but I ain't seen none of my life. So he's going with salmon. So.
Now that you try to change the venue.
He said I tried to change the venue. Well, because I remember last time we came here, we didn't eat. I don't even think we liked the food.
That's because we just drank.
That was years ago. That was years ago when we came here. We haven't been here in at least 5 years.
Yeah, about that. Probably so.
It's been a minute.
Hurricane.
It is. You look good drinking it too, babe. Love him. This apple martini is on point. It's strong too. Real strong. That's the strongest apple martini I've had in a long time.
It looks good though.
Huh?
It looks like it's good. Is it strong?
It's strong. You want to? It's strong. All right, guys. We're about to socialize for a little bit, but I'll catch you guys in a minute. one. Now y'all know I'm not gonna eat all this, right? Look at this. A couple of bites and I'm gonna be full. Like, you leaning already, baby? They've had salmon, potatoes, and shrimp, and broccoli. And I have this burger with fries.
That you ain't gonna eat.
He's gonna eat tonight when we get home. Because that's what he always eats. He always eats my food every time I take him. So, time to eat. Yum, yum, yum. Yep, guys. Mine is wrapped up and ready to go. I ain't making it. I did not make it. It's like no matter how hard I try, it just won't happen. It's just, it can't happen. Like, I can't eat food. Like, it's depressing. Did you like dinner, babe?
Pretty good.
He ain't like it. He ain't leaning like he usually leans.
Nah, I ate salmon and shrimp. I mean, it's pretty good.
And he still had a lot left on his plate.
I had a lot of mashed potatoes. I don't like skin to my mashed potatoes.
He doesn't like skin.
And I keep thinking about my car, too.
Your car?
Yeah, when I come up that curb, I had it straight the bottom of it.
Oh, you did. You did hit it pretty hard. And you looked at it, though, right?
It's on the bottom.
Oh, it's on the bottom, so you think it's...
Oh, no, I think it's all right, but still, you know, I just don't like scraping my foot. It's my boo. I don't like scraping my foot.
Oh, really? So that's your boo. He took his boo to get cleaned and waxed today.
Oh, yeah. Waxed that ass. Sure did.
You gonna take mine tomorrow?
You got the Beastie Boys?
Beastie Boys! Alright guys, this is where all the magic happened. Well, not necessarily right here. But back in that almost 15 years ago, well actually 15 years ago, this was a skating rink. Ice skating rink. Yeah, remember they were ice skating right here? They had a big ice skating rink right here. And we were walking around and came over here to our little spot.
The Lord told me to propose to
you. The Lord told you.
The Lord told me to do it.
He dropped it in your spirit.
He dropped it in my spirit. I was like, nah, I ain't gonna do it. He said, you better do it.
Get your good thing. You say, a man that findeth the wife finds a good thing. I mean, a good thing. So, this
is... Don't say what else you find.
Yeah, they don't. This is where he proposed to me at. So, oh my God. It's been, when was the last time we came here? Like 3-4 years ago?
Probably so.
Right here, guys. Right in the center, right where the light is, right there, is where he proposed to me. No ring in hand or nothing. We were so broke. We was just out here.
All we had was love, huh?
All we had was love. That's all it takes sometimes, love. Waterfall. Probably got a couple of quarters down there. Quarter or two.
Yep.
The aquarium is right over there. Huh?
Let's see if we can get
bugs. Let's see if we can
get bugs.
Bugs?
Yeah.
Why bye? Ain't it amazing how God can take you from nothing to something? Because when we were here, we had nothing. I think we were staying with somebody.
Shabba.
We was, I think we were living with someone. No, we had our own place.
Nah, we were staying with Pastor Cooper. No.
Oh.
We didn't have nothing.
We didn't have anything.
We didn't have nothing.
A pot to piss in or wanted to throw it out of. And it's amazing where we are now. We're getting ready to close on our second home, and our kids are going to some really good schools, and it's amazing, man. It's just amazing how far God has brought us. The waterfall. So nice. Yeah, guys, so it's a struggle, but you can get through it. I'm telling you, if we can make it 15 years, August to be 15 years, we've been together almost actually 16 years, but August married be 15 years.
Yeah.
And we were just discussing our plans for our 15-year marriage.
Yeah.
Probably have a big dinner, a nice dinner with all of our friends, and we always talk about why God allowed us to make it this far, and others have divorced and remarried and have other kids, and you know, it's not easy. I'll tell you that now. It is not, definitely not easy, but you can make it past that 10-year mark. You can get it. You can get somewhere. You got something to say?
Keep the faith. Keep the faith.
He said keep the faith. That's right, keep the faith. You know, our story is not your story. Your story is not our story. We've been through a lot, you know, to get where we are. And we still trying to get to other places. Still trying to figure it out. But, you know, keep God first in everything, and keep God first in your marriage, keep God first in your family, keep God first in your home, and it'll be okay. Nobody told me the road will be easy, but I don't believe he brought me this far to leave me. It sounds quirky, but it's true. So this is only a part of our story. But I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys go. We're gonna go ahead and enjoy this night, probably walk around for a little bit, enjoy the scenery, because it's been years since we've been down here. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, good night, guys.
Good night.
I can advise. I can have the best night of my life. I can own the cars, clothes, chains. But what you do to me is everything. Girl, I can own $1 billion company. Or get faded with these drugs on me. But it don't matter, 'cause I'm still here, thinking about you. Think about me. Girl, I got 40 bitches trying to holler, I don't wanna.